Hello and welcome to Telecom TV. I'm Martin Warwick. We're in The Hague in the Netherlands at the SDN NFV World Congress 2017. And I'm talking with Eric Debout, who is Head of NFV Solutions at Orange. Eric, we met yesterday and chatted. Good to see you here. Thanks for coming in. I want to ask you a few questions about the state of NFV, if I could. Let's start with this one. It's 5 years since the first NFV white paper was produced. In your view, where are we in terms of the viability of the technology and the adoption of it by CSPs?
So thank you for inviting me once again.
Pleasure.
It's a pleasure to share our vision. So yes, Fiverr it's fast on and it's maybe 5 years, but it's not a long time in the industry. So I think when we started this NFV white paper 5 years ago, we had a lot of expectation on cost reduction, typically.
Yeah.
We maybe underestimated the technology transformation and so on. But today, I think we can say we are there. The technology is quite mature. It's not perfect. We still have a lot of work to do. But we started the journey within Orange. We started with OBS on the enterprise market, launching the EasyGo offer to address international enterprise that have various sites across the world. The objective is to launch some kind of on-demand VPN connection with some added value services on top of it. So it's typically what we can do with SDN and NFV techniques. So we achieved that. So it's working now. In parallel, we work to define our infrastructure to support the various VNF for our core network. We had a lot of discussion with vendors, a lot of work in a standardization body. We also understood that we are in a software world. So software means a new way of collaborating. The ecosystem is not the same one. We also have new actors like IT players. We also now talking with hardware vendors to understand their evolution and so on. So it was quite new for us to have this, let's say, broader ecosystem for the network guys. And if we come back 5 years ago, on the network side, to be honest, we don't have any, let's say, IT skills or IT mindset.
True.
When we are talking about people, about API, agile method, it was not it was not in their
foreign language.
Yeah, it's foreign language, exactly.
Yeah.
So now it's we did a lot of progress on that. I think it's quite good. And we also learned how to work with open source community, because open source, it's quite new in the network. And the foundation for an AVI, Vim, and so on. So it's also important to learn how to work with the open source community. So as Orange, we jumped into this open source community, started with OpenStack, OpenDelight, and also we were a member founder for the OpenAV and also an app. So we learned quite a lot how to work in this ecosystem. So it's a different way of working.
Yes,
clearly.
Indeed.
But we now, I think, we are quite mature to understand how all these pieces work together. So, as mentioned yesterday by Emmanuel, so we are in a phase to industrialize our NFV deployment across all our affiliates, because Orange is a group with many countries across Europe and many Africa.
Yep.
So we define our strategy for our infrastructure. We have selected some vendors and we integrate all these pieces together. And now we define also our internal roadmap to deploy some VNF in various countries. We started also to define some kind of tooling to check internally that the VNF can run on top of our infrastructure. So we did quite a lot of job. And now we have to deploy at large scale in various countries. So it will be the topic for next year.
Of course.
Of course. So it's I think the technology is quite mature. And as I said in the previous interview in Beijing, it's not only a technology problem, because as an engineer we are always able to solve problems, but we need also to tackle all the impact in terms of process. So between the design phase and the runtime phase, the operational guides and so on, and that's, we still have a lot of work to do on that topic.
What is happening at the moment, it seems to me, Eric, is that we're starting to hear a lot, and as NFV matures and it becomes accepted within the industry in general, we're now starting to hear a lot about automation, about AI and about machine learning and so on. What do you think these will mean in the context of the network transformation that we're seeing and talking about, and how important will they be?
Yeah, so it's true. Yes, I think yesterday keywords were automation, yes. Machine learning. Yes. So why? I think you have many things that are coming at the same time.
Yeah.
We know that some vendors are delivering some their VNF in a monthly basis. So we need to adapt also our process to automate our validation and so on, or any kind of process to integrate their new release in our network. So we need to change the way we validate the solution, and we should use automation as much as possible.
Sure.
And automation is possible also today because as we are using much more, let's say, IT techniques, there's a lot of tools coming from the IT world to automate API and so on.
Yes.
So we can reuse these tools. These tools are available. I think we also change in our mind to get this agility to deploy the VNF fast. We know that we should automate as much as possible, let's say, all the tasks we performed manually previously, because we had time to do that. But now we have no more time. And once we have no more time, a second, the techniques are ready. And third, we can find now some some good tooling in the open source community to help us to reach this automation goal. So yes, I think it's the combination of all of these factors that why we are talking about automation. And maybe ONAP also played a great role on that, because I think at CNAV did a very very good job to define the framework for NFV, but didn't embrace the full picture, while ONAP did that. And so focusing on automation, the A on ONAP is automation. So I think it's also a good message to the industry to say it's possible to automate as much as possible.
Yes.
But when we say automation, when we say zero touch automation, typically that means we'll try to define some models, some rules, and so on. We will have all the tooling, the machinery to execute all these rules and these models. But we still need to have some people working on this machinery.
Of course.
We need to have some people, yeah, to get the intelligence,
yes,
to know what value we should put on the rules. We need to have very, very good skills to analyze errors, because when you have errors in such complex solution, you need to have very good people to analyze what happened. Yeah, what's happened. So we need to have these skills, and we need to have people to maintain all this machinery, and maybe to automate from the vendor part towards the service provider part.
Yep.
So there's still a lot of work to do, but I think we are in a good way to do that. And after, I think machine learning will arrive after that. We need to automate as much as possible, and after we'll capture a lot of data from the VNF, from the infrastructure and so on. If we want to predict some errors, machine learning can help us. We did some POC in our labs. We know it's possible, but to be deployed in real life, it's another topic. We need to prove that you can start automation for the deployment phase, maybe for let's say some monitoring and the closed loop, but step by step.
Of course.
And once you have defined the rules, when you know that you can automate as much as possible when you get all this data coming from all your various pieces, you may start thinking about machine learning, intelligence artificial, and so on. But
an evolutionary step by step.
Yeah. It should be step by step. So we addressed that in the panel yesterday.
Yes.
Foundation first, and after you can build on top of it. But I think yes, it's a very interesting topic, and that give a good let's say a good vision where we should go in the next 5 years, maybe.
Thank you. What surprised you the most in the 5 years of the NFV journey so far?
I think what I said previously, it's a transformation towards IT. Really, we network guys now are talking the IT language. And I think, yes, we are there today.
If you could borrow the telecom TV time machine, I don't know where it is. if you could borrow the telecom TV time machine and change one thing that's happened over the past 5 years as far as NFV is concerned, what would you do?
I think we should start to act as a startup, starting with what we call the MVP.
Yeah.
And just working on this MVP, both at the specification layer, reference implementation, and so on. And start small, but covering all the scope, the specification and code, reference code, and so on. Because I think we spend maybe some time defining, let's say, a beautiful target architecture.
Yes.
We should have focused maybe on a small set of, let's say, of concept, covering, let's say, specification, all the code, and after progressing.
Now, making predictions in telecommunications industry is a silly thing to do. And I certainly don't think you can look more than a year ahead anyway, whatever happens. But let's say this journey to NFV is a 10-year process. We're about halfway through it. What is your prediction of what the network will look like with everything we've been talking about, with AI, machine learning, automation, cloudification, everything else? What will it look like in 5 years' time, do you think?
I hope we can have some kind of full automation.
Yep.
In the network, in the operational network, I mean. I hope it will be the full standard way to operate the network in 5 years, with maybe some kind of machine learning and artificial intelligence, maybe. We should have some part of this deployed in the network in 5 years. I think so. Yes, I think so.
Very interesting stuff. Eric Beau, thank you very much indeed.
So thank you for this interview.